Classic car or muscle car, we want to show you how to restore your automobile and save yourself some money in the process. Sometimes we consult the pros, sometimes we mess up. But just remember, it's never a problem, it's always a project.
This week on Autorestomod, Jeff is at MPD for the Silver Spring Show, Dustin doesn't like early mornings, and we take a look at the new seats from TMI products.
Order a bunch of parts to get ready for the car show this weekend?
And I got a hot deal, too.
You think? Think again.
Oh, man.
Tired of back orders? You need NPD. With four strategically located superstores, orders are shipped direct to your door within 1 to 3 business days. National Parts Depot has quality restoration parts for Ford truck, Mustang, Camaro, Chevelle, and Firebird. For your free catalog, visit NPD online or call toll-free.
All right, we're here at the NPD Silver Springs All Ford Show, and we managed to grab Dean to do a little bit of an interview with him on the new seats that they've gotten. And we showed you these a little while back, right before SEMA, and a couple of guys had some things to say about it. So we're gonna address a little bit of that right now. So Dean, this is basically an all new seat, right?
Exactly, this is our new Pro Series seat, which solves a big problem for people who they like their old seat, but they didn't have adjustability or the frame is broken. How do they get modern seating into a classic car or any kind of car as well? So this is our high back version and our low back version.
Now, what if I've got a 65 Mustang? Is this seat gonna go in to the 65 Mustang? I mean, do you guys have a way to put that in the car, or does it just come without the tracks and stuff?
No, it comes complete with the sliders as well as the mounts to bring it to put it to the floor, and it can adapt it to an early Mustang, a later Mustang, even a Camaro or a Chevelle.
Wow, so I mean, and this kind of a setup that you got here, if I had something that was a little bit more odd, say I've got a 64 Falcon and I wanted to do it and I wanted to make my own setups, it's still available to do the different heights and stuff that you might want to set the car up with,
yes,
right?
Yes, the proper mounts to get into any particular vehicle are going to be available for each of those different models, whether it's a classic Mustang, which we're known for, or not.
Sure. Now, in a seat like this, I mean, these are obviously your custom seat covers. Do you have anything that's less high end? I mean, not a leather setup and stuff. Do you have something that's a little less expensive than what you've got seen?
Yes, this is our top of the line. This is the XR version, which has the grommets and the suede and the contrast stitching. This is really the highest end appearance package for a performance looking seating package. We also have them in standard original materials, so it'll look just like it's a factory type of seat. But some of the key features is that older seats never had tilting or locking or adjustability to them. They're basically kind of a static seat, and this actually has a complete ability to not only tilt it forward and lock it in place, but also to rotate it back into a reclined position too.
And so these have got the knobs on the back so that you can tilt it all the way forward. If you want to, for some bizarre reason, put somebody in the back seat of your car,
exactly,
you could get them back there.
Yes.
So and you have a full recline feature, because you and I have talked about this a while back, and I mean, you've been on your case for a good while to have some kind of seat with your seat covers that's a fully reclining setup.
Exactly, and it solves a world of situations for people who have cars. I like the car, but I want to get a better seat into it, and so it solves that problem.
Well, and the nice thing about this is you can do anything from very wild to very mild. So we didn't know when we were first talking to you about this whether or not you were going to have any different kind of seats available. So I'm going to say we're going to pull all this stuff down real quick and we're going to bring in the other seat, because you've brought something here this week that I didn't even know that you were doing. We'll get the other seat in here so you can see that this is not the only seat cover that's available from the guys at TMI. All right, Dean, that looks remarkably like a sports seat for a 65 Mustang or whatever. I mean, you know, obviously it's got a 65 six pony insert in it.
Yes.
And it looks like a vintage seat, which is why I've liked these things from the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
This is even more exciting to me, because I'm assuming for Chevelle, Camaro, whatever you're working on, you guys have a seat pattern that will go on there looking like a factory seat.
Yes.
Now, you were talking a little bit about, what about the way that you adjust it and get in and out of the back of it? Because like we were saying, kind of like, you know, nobody wants to be in the back seat of an old car, but when you have things to put back there, what do you do to get back there with this?
Well, we designed this frame for that purpose. It basically solves a lot of those limitations that were in the old cars from locking backrests and safety issues. But if it's going to look like an old seat, that's one thing, but performing is different. This has a release mechanism here and here to flip forward, which you don't have that locking backrest in the earlier Mustangs, especially in a lot of the classic cars. And then you have an adjusting knob that allows you to set the position for your comfort, pitch it all the way back if you like. We have the sliders.
Kind of do the gangsta lean if you want.
Precisely. Yeah, that's the main reason for that feature. It's got a nice long sliding track on the front, so that actually it can go 6 to 7 inches. The mounts adapted to each every car, so it looks like it's designed to fit in that car at the right height, the right distance in the floor.
Well, you and I have talked about this before. If you got an aftermarket seat, it looked like a Recaro bucket, and to my mind, a lot of times in these vintage cars, it really didn't look like it belonged. All right, so Dean, let's say the guy's got a 69 Firebird, Camaro, Mustang, whatever, and it's a headrest car and he wants to put headrests back in there. A lot of people like that for the safety of, you know, Lord forbid you get into an accident.
Certainly.
You know, it'll keep you from getting whiplash. So if a guy wanted to put headrests in the car, can you guys do that with these seats?
Yes, and we've designed classic headrests for the classic Mustang as well that adapt right to the frame to add that extra level of safety. We incorporated those same features into this aftermarket seat also so that you can have a small headrest on the top to give that extra bit of safety to the car as well.
What's y'all's retail point on these as far as a completely good to go vinyl bucket? Let's say the guy wanted to do the pony seat covers on it. What would be the price point on a complete seat?
A pair of buckets with the foam and the covers that go with it, probably under $1,000.
Wow. Here you could have a seat in a high back even.
Yes.
That's a nice, real form-fitting seat that'll hold you in there. Because, I mean, let's face it, the old bucket seats, they're really not designed to hold a guy in the car.
No. We've dealt with that as best we could with our sport seats for the classic Mustangs and Camaros and Chevelles and other vehicles. But, you know, this takes it to a whole new level. You can get a brand new seat, all the seat features, but the comfort and performance that you expect out of a modern seat, but still make it look like it belongs in your car.
And we've talked about this on the show a good bit. Here in the last few years, it seems like there are so many things coming out for the classic cars now to bring them into the modern age that, you know, it makes it almost where, man, it'd make it a nice driver for every day now rather than sitting there saying, man, I don't want to ride in this car because it's got a really nasty bench seat and it's uncomfortable. Now you can put a set of buckets in whatever you're working on and get a nice feel for your bottom and hopefully your back as well. So I am really digging these. I mean, when you first told me these were coming out, I was very excited. I mean, I was like, okay, when are these coming out? What are you guys gonna do with them? What's gonna be available? And I saw and I'm like, well, these are cool because, as I said before, they don't look like a Recaro style bucket. Not that there's anything wrong with that look.
No.
But a lot of guys want that classic look in their cars.
Exactly.
All right, Dean. So you got seats.
Yes, we do.
What else you got? I mean, come on. I mean, a guy, if he just got the seats, what's he got? I mean, that's really nice, but it's going to look really wide, like kind of poor with a stock door
panel. You're right. It's great to have a great seat, but wait, there's more.
He's suddenly one of those Ginsu Knight.
Exactly. We are the Ginsu Knight maker of interiors.
Wow, that is nice. Now, this is a Mustang one, right?
Yeah, this is a 67, 68 Mustang Sport R door panel. Completely covers the whole door, fits over entirely instead of just the insert section, which they're normally known for. Add the suede insert. We also can do this in standard colors as well, but this is our Sport R, which has the contrast stitching. It's just the pinnacle of customizing without having to go to a custom shop and pay incredible amount of money
get
this done. I mean, just really for, well, actually, it would be $500-$600, you'd have a set of perfectly contoured, sculpted, personalized type of panels.
Now, I mean, this is for the Mustang. I know you guys are probably going to be doing some stuff for the Camaros, Firebird, stuff like that as well, right? Exactly. Are those out yet?
Yes, some of the Camaro stuff is out right now, and even more is coming down the line as well.
Okay, so you got door panels. What else you got? I mean, is there anything else? Because you're pulling out stuff like a rabbit out of a hat. Nope. So is there anything else you got?
I might have something else. Let me see.
Wow, Dean, you just happen to have a console.
Yeah, my pockets are pretty big, yes. So I've got our new Sport console, the Sport R console, because again, it has the contrast stitching, has the suede inserts on the sides, as well as the matching Mustang type of door panel trim, as well as integrated right into it. One of the cool things, it has a double DIN insert, so it'll accept navigation or a gauge cluster or anything in that section right there. And this is actually contoured for a 67.8 Mustang as well.
So that'll fit right up underneath the radio opening on a 67.8.
Perfectly, yes. Also, it's got, you know, cup holders, which classic Mustangs never had those kind of things.
Well, they did, but they were on the glove box, and I don't really would not consider that a holder much. It's more of a place to set your
cup. Better not be moving.
No, especially with hot McDonald's coffee.
Not at all. You don't want
to do that.
Also has a storage compartment in here as well with a nice ABS tray as well, matte pocket. It looked cool and racy.
All right, so we got the door panels. We've got the console. You know where I'm going with this. What else you got?
We've got one-piece molded headliners.
Really?
Oh yeah. You take out the bows and the inches you lose from that and this kind of a sail panel type of thing up on top. And it's a one piece molded out of ABS plastic that is covered with either suede or vinyl or some other type of custom material as well. And it's really cool. You gain 2 inches of headroom just by putting it in the car.
And in a Mustang, that's huge.
Right.
Especially in a fastback, because you and I both know the fastbacks are horrible for guys that are like me, tall from the waist up. In my 67 yep. that we do the Night Mistress, we actually had to go in on that car and suck 2 inches out of the seat pan
yep.
so I wasn't sitting in the car with my head kind of kicked over like
this.
It's
a simple way to gain that extra height that you need and clearance. And we've been hearing about it for a long time and came up with this idea. It's a beautiful, complete package, and you do not have to take the glass out to put it in.
Really?
Leave it in there because it snugs right up to the gaskets at the front and the rear.
That's pretty interesting. So, okay, for the guys with the Firebird Camaros,
yep.
what do they got?
That's coming on down the pike a little later in 2014.
Okay, so you've got pretty much, if I wanted to do a custom interior, a real custom look interior, the nice thing is I'm looking at what you've got here. A guy comes to you guys, picks up a brand new set of seats.
Yep.
You know, if he wants to get away from the original buckets, but even if he doesn't want to get away from his original buckets, you guys have the sport, foam and upholstery that he can put in his original buckets. Do that
yep.
way, put in a nice set of aftermarket door panels for a Mustang that are molded, and then also add a console to it.
Yeah, and for the person on a budget, it's a perfect thing. You can start going phase by phase and get stuff and complete your custom interior over the course of time, and it's all going to look like it fits, matches, and cost effective too.
Now here you guys are also working on a couple of dash pads for the Mustang, is that?
Yes. It'll be in the same vein as you see right now.
When are these phantom dash pads supposed to be available?
They should be available in the next 90 days.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
So that's coming pretty quick then.
They take the dash pad and make it a sculpted piece that basically blends right back into the cool interior that you already have.
I was going to say, because y'all are doing it in the same vinyls and leathers, if a guy wanted, could you do a leather one for a guy if he wanted, or
yes,
is that available?
Yeah, we do a lot of leather for a lot of people. About half of the orders that we take anymore are custom. I mean, there are patterns, we have a lot of patterns,
sure.
but I want this color, I want this type of stitch. We're happy to do that kind of stuff.
And you guys have a ton of different vinyls and leathers available. I mean, I remember you sent me a ring, and that ring has all the different vinyls and leathers that you got stock, and it's a pretty stout little ring.
I didn't send you all of them.
Oh.
I shortchanged you. We have probably double or triple that amount actually available.
Really?
I got a warehouse full of vinyls that we have made exclusively for us, and some that are off the shelf, but most of them are made exclusively for us, and we run those by the thousands and thousands of yards. And then we have hundreds and hundreds of hides of different colored cows.
So, like purple cows?
We have some. I have some screaming yellow leather in there. I've got a whole bunch of that for the late model of a Mustang. Really?
I'd like to see a screaming yellow cow. That would be
You
brilliant.
Do not want to see a screaming yellow cow.
All right, Dean, this is amazing. I mean, I realized you guys had some stuff coming out, but I didn't know that you were going that deep with it. I mean, this is more than I anticipated seeing out of this. I thought we'd get a look at a couple of seats, and that would be it. But it turns out you guys are doing pretty much everything for a custom interior look.
Our design team, we are car guys too.
Sure.
We love this business, and we listen to what the people want. And the consumers have told us, we want something cool and custom, and so we're giving it to them.
Because you guys did a 66 or 67 Fairlane for the SEMA show this year, right?
1967 Gulf Racing Fairlane, and it has our Sport XR seat. And it came out great. It's getting a lot of great coverage, but it's a very cool build as well. But again, it's not a Mustang. But it fits in there, and it's using our Pro Series.
Well, this is going to allow you to get in a lot of markets that you haven't been able to get into before, just simply because you weren't doing the Fairlane stuff. But if a guy's got a Fairlane, and I can tell you right now, a set of Fairlane original buckets, they're hard to find because those cars are just not in the salvage yards anymore. If a guy's got a car that was a bench seat,
yes.
two-door hardtop, he's got a nice alternative that looks like a factory seat.
Exactly.
Now.
The Fairlane we did was a bench seat car. Actually, it was a six-cylinder car. Now it's got a 427 in it.
That's a really nice little upgrade.
Yeah, it's just a slight bit of a power upgrade.
Well, Dean, I really appreciate you coming out, man. This is great, and we'll probably be getting with you. I know we got the 64 Falcon. You and I have talked about doing
yes.
a set of these seats in the Falcon, so we'll be doing an install on that down the road for you
we're
guys.
We're looking forward to it.
And basically past that, who knows what you guys are going to get into.
That's a good question.
All right, folks, that's our show for this week. Be sure to come back and watch us next time on Autorestomod.